Hello traders, again welcome back to my video. So today I'm going to take trade with rejection area on the basis of the rejection areas. So in the Euro JPY here now we can see some sellers entry. So here I'm going to place a put option from this level. Here there is no opportunity, and here also, okay, now the time is over. So we can trade after the closing of these candles. So today I will take trade only on the basis of the rejection areas. Okay, you can see the market is ranging, okay, and there is a level here. So you can see some bullish entry now, but finally the buyers don't make any strong candle here. You can see it was very weak bullish candle, okay, but most of the time it should be bearish. So here I'm going to place put option, and here also we can go to the buyers with some margin of 50. Here if it come again up, then we can, okay, here I'm going to place a put option. Okay, very good entry because now I placed at the level. Okay, it should reject. Definitely it should reject. You can see rejection now, and it also should reject because here also I placed my entry exactly at the rejection area. So when the market hit that level, it should definitely reject. Okay, so you can see finally it made a very weak bearish candle. Okay, so here, oh, it's closed exactly my entry, but here there is a new high. Here also you can see some strong rejection. That's why I told you that it will reject. When it hit the level, it should reject. So here there is a new high. So here I'm not confident. Okay, here I'm going to place call option. Okay, it's very good entry. Okay, the time is over. Here I placed call option because here I am not confident to go to the sellers. That's why I placed here call option, and my entry is very good because there is a level here. You can see it is rejecting from the same level, and you can see suddenly buyers are entered also. So still there is a gap. There is a new high in the previous bullish candle. It indicates the buyers pressure to go more up, not sellers rejection. That's why I placed here call option, and now the present candle may be bearish. Here is a momentum, strong bullish entry. There is no, so here I'm going to place call option. Here also we can go to the buyers. Here also I'm going to place call option with some margin of safety. Here I'm not confident because it may reject after hitting that level also. But here there is a breakout. Here there is a momentum, that's why I placed here a call option, but here also breakout of that round number, so we can expect retracement also if the market make any retracement. But here it should reject, definitely it should reject. Oof. Okay, I think one, okay, it was winning trade, and here I'm going to place put option. Very good entry. Here it was doji candle. Okay, here, okay, it's very good entry. I expect it should be a weak bullish, something like that. That's why I placed put option with some margin of safety. So today I will take some unlimited trades in the rejection area like this, so I don't stop after this. I will take more trades to show you how to predict the candles based on the rejection areas using the price action. I don't know, I think there is no rejection, but I expect it should reject. Okay, finally it closes. Doji candle. Okay, I told you that that may be weak, bullish. That's why I placed my entry with sellers with some margin of safety. Okay, when you are trading in the SNR level, must keep a margin of safety. You can easily get more and more ITMs. Okay, here two bearish entries. So here I'm going to place put option. I placed here put option because now I'm seeing two bearish strong candles. It didn't reach at the level, means definitely it should go down after hitting that level. Okay, that's why I placed here put option, and I got very good entry also. It one also I placed exactly at the rejection point. Okay, so if you know about how to trade in the rejection area also, you can easily get good profit. Okay, can see strong bearish entry. Okay, here there is a momentum, there is a bullish momentum. So here I'm going to place call option with some margin of safety. Oh bullshit, I don't get margin of safety here. Here also it's better to place put option with some margin of safety, but now I'm not confident here. Here, but I want to place my trade below. At least, just wait, I will show that. At least this area. If I get this area, I mean, if I get my entry almost this level, then it should be a winning trade. But I don't get my entry. I think it may be losing trade. Okay, I think it's. Oh, it's again doji. So, next one. You can see bullish entry after that doji, same doji, we can expect bullish entry, but here there is a downtrend, and here the thing, now I got I don't get any loss, but I got ATM at the money, 4 ATM, no profit, no loss. Okay, but I didn't get any loss still now. But I will take some more trades after the closing of this candle. So because today I take trade only on the basis of the rejection areas. Okay, so it's very simple to trade on the basis of the rejection area. Okay, anyone can trade, there is no need for much knowledge to trade like this on the basis of the rejection point or rejection areas. Okay, here now we can see some sellers on this, so we can go to the sellers, and here there is a round number. In this space there is no trading opportunity, I think, so no problem. Here the next one may be bullish because it's a breakout, and now we can see some strong sellers entry. So after this, as possible, I will take trade all in the space in the same time. So it should be bearish because now there is a momentum, but I don't know why it should be bearish. 98% it should be bearish. Okay, you can see, but it's very weak bearish, which means now the sellers are not interested to go more down. You can see again bullish entry. Okay, that's why we are seeing bullish entry now. You can see some weakness in the case of sellers. That's why now we are seeing bullish entry. So I need to analyze all the market because the market is not much good now, but I am going to trade in all the pairs in the same time as possible. But the fast momentum is an issue in this kind of market. It's a major issue of 1 minute trading. So okay, now here two bullish entry, but there is a level. So anyway, I'm going to place here call option, and here Also, I'm going to play score option. Here, next one should be bearish, but I need a good entry. Okay, here we can go to the sellers. Here, it's better to place put option with some margin of 50. But I need a good entry. Okay, here I'm going to place put option. Here also I'm going to place call option with some margin of safety. Here, oh, but I didn't get my entry because of fast momentum. Here the candle should be bullish. That's the most probability. Here I placed at the rejection area, but I think here it may be going to a losing trade because there is a level in the left side, but I expect that because of that two bullish candle, it may be go up, but it didn't go up. It may be losing trade. Okay, one loss, others was winning trade. One loss, that's common, there is no problem. I think I got one loss now. Okay, I will cover losses are common, and there is no any other loss in this section. Only one loss now. I will cover that amount, don't worry. The losses are common because we are trading the binary option. The risk is very high, but if you know about the candlestick psychology, it's very easy to predict. I will cover, definitely I will cover this loss. Okay, so I will do one more, like I mean again I will trade all in this space in the same time as possible. So we can wait for the closing of this present candle. But you don't do like this if you don't have the proper knowledge. Okay, finally you can see it's sellers and so here I'm going to place call option. And here I'm not confident. Here also we can go to the bias with some marginal safety. Here I'm going to place put option. Here also we can go to the bias with some marginal safety. Here also we can go to the bias. We can go to sellers here. There's a new low here. But there's a level also. Okay, I think maybe rejection also, but this trade is little bit risky, but there is a level because no problem. Here there's some momentum. I felt it should go down, that's why I placed here put option, but there is no rejection now. It's only a fake movement, but the market didn't draw us now. Again bias entry. Okay, I think I go two lows now. Okay, one or two lows now. I think, okay, I go two lows now. Okay, no problem, I will recover my loss. Okay, definitely I will recover my loss. So here, yeah, the market getting bad. Okay, so no problem, I will trade after the closing of this candle, then I will definitely recover my loss. Okay, so okay, here now we can see some rejection. And if you are not joined in my Telegram channel, you can find the link on the description. Here I'm going to place a put option, and here I'm going to place a call option. Oh bullshit, there is late entry because of momentum. Here also we can go to the sellers. Okay, very good entry. Here also I'm going to place a put option with some margin of safety. I should reject. Here it's very weak candle, but there's a breakout. Sorry, there is a strong candle, not a weak candle. Here we can go to sellers with some margin of safety. Okay, now I placed exactly at this rejection point, so it should reject. It should definitely reject after hitting that level. Okay, that's why I placed like that. That's how trading the predicting candle with rejection area. You can see rejection now. Okay, from that point or above of that level at the raw number, it's rejecting like that. But here also I think again one loss. Okay, no problem, I will recover. Again I go two losses, not one loss, again I go two losses, but no problem, I will recover that also. Okay, losses are common because it's binary trading, the losses are common, and because of some news effect also anyone can get. Here there's a new high, so I'm going to place a call option. Okay, here don't think like this, oh it's a rejection, it's a don't think like that. Okay, it's only buying pressure. Now I think I place so many trades, I think near to 40 trades, something like that, I mean 4-0. Okay, you can see here also bias entry because it's a buying pressure, because the momentum, bias momentum that we are seeing. If you see a momentum like this and if you see a wicks like this, most of the time it should go up. Okay, it don't reverse, it should go up if you see a momentum plus a new high like this. Here there is a spinning top at the level, so we can go to the bias here, and here I'm going to place a put option. Here I don't know what is happening to doji, so here also we can go to the bias. Okay, very good entry, and here also next one should be bullish. Oh, it's the time is over now, so okay, you can see bullish entry and rejection now, and here also bullish entry. Okay, so after this I will stop my trading because it's enough. Today I took more than 40 trades or near to 40 trades, something like that. That's enough for this section. So if anyone have any doubts about this, you can ask me, I will make it clear. And it's not, again I am telling that it's not a complicated things to trade in the binary option. Okay, because if you know about the candlestick psychology or a good strategy, if you have, you can predict like this. You can see today result, and it was the result. So it's not a complicated thing to predict the candles in the binary option, but so many people telling that the binary options are scam. Actually they don't know how to trade in the binary option, that's why that kind of people telling that the binary options are scam. So anyway, I'm going to stop this video. All of you, wish you good profit.